Hello, welcome back to Coldborough Park Farm with me, MrCosmicNite. Okay, we'll carry on when we left off. We just need to pick up these barrels as best we can. So we're going to use our new bit of kit. I think I'm going to do this from outside view. Just turn off head tracking for a second. Just so I get the hang of it, I think it's just going to be a little bit easier. So we're going to make little stacks of four. So we put this in working mode. Let's see how we get on it. Not the easiest. I have tested this. It's not the easiest thing in the world to use. It's not too bad. I don't always want to go in. There we go. So we've got the first one. So we've got to grab onto that and lift it up. Alright, let's try and get another bale that's facing our direction. Right, so we... Oh, wrong buttons. So we don't do that, we let go, grab on, lift that one up. Alright, okay, let's try and get this one. No, come back for that. Let's try and line this one up nicely. Is that going to go? No, that just needs a little bit of something this side. Oh, there we go. I think that just had it there. So we let go, lower, grab on, lift up. Get that one. Like I say, it's not. It hasn't got the auto grab script like the other ones have. But it's not too bad. It's certainly going to make you if you struggle with the front loader. I think it's certainly going to help. Right, so now we've got four. We can just leave them there. So I probably won't get all of these on camera, but do a few stacks anyway. I think it's one of them things, once you get the hang of it, you can probably get along quite quickly. It's just... if you can get the bales in cleanly, I think you're laughing. Yep, that one's going in. No. I think we probably will upgrade from this reasonably quickly. But it just makes a nice change, you sound slightly different. Go on, get in. There we go. Well, that was going a long way back. So what you can do actually, you can, I'll drop that on top there, I'll pull this forwards. There we go, make a nice neat stack. There me veil. No, fluff that one up. Has anyone else used this? I'd be interested to know how everyone else gets on. I feel it could just do with a little bit more of a guide to get the bales in. Yeah, they seem to want to get stuck. There we go. Let's get this one here. I'd imagine the more time you spend. No. Easier it would be. Concentrating hard at the moment. Trying not to show myself up. That's not where you go, is it? Not even close. I think I'm making hard work of this. When I got it, I thought, oh yeah, this would be easy. Just whip me out and get all these bales. Spin that right down to try and not do that. Okay, I'll do one more stack and then I'll just pause the video and finish this off camera. Yeah, you have to use the numpad 7, open and close is the claws. 8 lifts the bales up, and 9 releases them. No, that's not going to work. Let's try and fire one that's facing our direction. Yeah, a couple there. No, it's not going in. Well, I don't know how long I'm going to keep this thing for. We'll go in. Go in. Well, I must admit, I like the idea of it. So that's not even going to go in, is it? Because it's too low. Let's try and lift these up again. Here we go. Okay. Yeah. I'm not 100% sure about this. Had an extra rail this side and they just slid in. So that bale there is just not high enough, is it? That's just not lifting it high enough. There we go this time. No, I don't think their bales are going to let it in. Might be because of the uneven ground, that might work okay out of flat field. There we go. Right, well I think I'm going to just pause the video here, try and get the rest of these lined up. I don't want to spend too much longer on these bales because last episode was pretty much focused on this field, so we've still got lots more to do. So I'm just going to pause it here and I'll be back in a second. Okay, I think I've got them all. There's one left over. I don't think there's any more stragglers. Oh, it's been a bit of an ordeal, but all in all, actually, it's a really good mod. I just think the bale physics let it down a little bit, because in real life, straw bales are actually quite slippery and they would slide in the front there without too much trouble. But all in all, I mean, it is a lovely, cheap little auto loader. If you was in the market for one, I would I suppose I would recommend it. I was slowly getting better. I suppose with a bit of practice lining it up, you've got to get it perfect every time. Let's just go and get the trailer. Going to go and park this in the middle of the field, and then hopefully it'll all become clear why I went down this route, because it shouldn't be too difficult to load this trailer. Famous last words. Okay, park you there, turn the engine off. Oh, someone's having fun. Looks like you're nearly finished. Right, let's just finish him off. And then we move this into the old field 4 over there. Don't think we're going to get this in one run, so cut it in half. Because if you can't quite get it all in one run, the best practice is to cut it in half, because the reason for that is you want the combine as full as possible. So if you've only got a little bit of straw and crop going through the front, it doesn't do quite as good job threshing it as if it's full. So you'd always give as much as you can, because it helps fill it up and it just does a better job, more efficient. Let's just get these little bits over here. Spouts out. Where did the trailer go? It was over there, I think. Turn you off for a minute. Better, because you're going now. Cool. We'll just empty this in there and then head over there. I think there's a gate to this field. Can't remember now. No, it doesn't look like it. So if we just bring up auto combine, we're going to keep that on the left, I think. And away you go. Come back to that in a minute. Right. Okay, so we've got the old headlook sorted out. Let's try and make hard work of this, shall we? So this thing, I think, is rated at 3 bales, but I think we can probably get away with doing 4. And then, oh, if we push X, no. What's the? Oh, I know. Hold on. I think it is X. Yeah, attach bales. Why's that not working? We'll come back to that one. Because what it should do is you get the little tines there. Well, it's not animated, but they rotate into the bales, so the bales shouldn't fall over. Has that got it? I think that's got it, yeah. So you can then effectively do what you want with them. And it shouldn't fall out. I don't know why that didn't work first time. There we go. Try and get it nice and tight. I don't know how many we can get in here, but keep it on there. Push X, releases it. And then we've got 4 bales on there straight away. Where's the next stack goes over here? Not the straightest ones in the world. Should be okay. Okay, that's got it. Oh, why hasn't that worked? Just try and get that lined up as best we can. Maybe I think that might have been tilted forwards a little bit. Make sure all the tines are in. Let's go. So fingers crossed. Should be able to get this on there. That pushing the other bales. Okay, that'd be okay. And then the trick after this is getting it back to the farm without them all falling off. So, depending on how that goes, I might just sell it all and go and buy the auto stacker anyway. But this was kind of my plan to making it easy I'm not very straight. This is where a telehand would be easy with the four-wheel steer, to be honest. Back that out of there, lovely. So we're not going to get... Oh, maybe one more. Might get 2 more on there. Is there any more over there? apart from the one that fell over. I think we can have maybe another half a load after this load. But these bales should last us a while. We haven't got that much cattle. I'm quite pleased with this front attachment though. It seems to be working quite well. All in all, I'm pretty pleased with it. No, we're not going to get any more in the back, so there's no point in putting them really tight. Oh, that looks like, is that leaning this way? It's just the way the trailer's sitting. Oh dear. Just going to give that a little bit of a push, because when we get to the other farm we've got to try and get these off of here as well. So shouldn't be too difficult, because what happens is they get stuck to the trailer. I think that's got it now. Right, two more stacks, and then we'll head over to the farm, dairy farm. I think what I was thinking about this morning, what I'm going to do at the dairy farm, where the sheep are, is have square bales, because we've got the silage clamp, and then at the cattle breeding, like the beef and the pork barns, probably have round bales, so I can have silage bales there, you see. So I think that would probably work best. Okay, oh, my cat's saying hello. Now she's climbing all over me. Okay, let's just get these ones. Letting them all fall over. Got them. Where's the trailer? Yeah, I'm not convinced these are going to stay on there, to be honest. But I'm just going to put these on the end. Okay, how does that look? It's not the neatest trailer I've ever stacked, but I think it'll probably be okay. I think what I'm going to do is just turn the head looking off for a second. I'm just going to put this on follow that one, and I'm going to drive this one very carefully. Hey, steady on. Down to the dairy. Slow down. Slow down. Oh, that's going, look. Oh, it almost went. Flippy neck. Maybe too high is enough. Oh, blimey, how they stayed on there, I don't know. Yeah, I think I'm gonna... I think, oh, for the sake of 50 grand. And these hills, where is it? 45, it's actually cheaper than I thought. I think I'm gonna sell everything by that. Oh dear. I have got a transfer set up between this farm and the other, but I'm not going to risk it. And I'm not going to pause it, because this is, what's that combine doing? Hold on, I'm just going to get that combine going. Once it's been around months, it should be okay. I don't know if it's less stressful staying in the cab. God, I could do some straps to put over it, really. Lights on as well. I think we're going to need all the help we can get. Hopefully, yeah, it was still following. Don't crash into me though. Should be okay once we get on the road. Put a foot down. There we go. Nice and smooth. So that's one problem with this map. No roads this smooth in England. They're full of potholes and rough as anything, and I know that because I ride a motorbike. Okay, right. Fortunately, it's not too far down here. Just going to spawn neck it in. Nice and slow. I think all in all that's gone quite well. As far as moving bales in this game is concerned, I think that's absolute success. Well, we'll stick them in the left side, I think, because the bale is in the other one. So if I just bring this here, hopefully not sell any. Right, turn you off. You stopped again, lovely. Let's just get these off, and I think we're almost going to be at the end of the episode. This shouldn't be too difficult though. We should get these off reasonably quickly. Oh, stuck to the trailer. As we drop them off. Look at that. Four bales, no problem at all. I wonder how high we can stack these eight high. probably just going to keep quiet just while I concentrate on getting these off. Let's get the two at the back here. Hopefully this will have enough reach on it. Yeah, it looks like it should be okay. Try not to knock them over. Oh. Oh no. Oh. They're all stuck to each other. There we go. Didn't really want to take two from that stack. Just going to really push these in there now. Get that nice and tidy. And we'll put hay bales in the other side, I think. Probably do that. Make a start on that next episode. Get the little tractor. This tractor probably on the mower. I think we've got another couple of grass fields to cut. And then we're about to get our cows up to 100% productivity, which would be nice. And then we make a start on some... right in there? Nah, I thought they could go in there a bit more. Must just be caught over there. There we go. Push that in. Two more. Lovely, lovely. Just get these four. So I don't know what the fuss is about. Blimey. Right, well, I think let's just get out and admire our handiwork. But, that's not too bad, and we've still got a load more in that field, actually. But I'm not going to do that on camera. Oh, just actually, very quickly. I just want to, show you something. There's a couple of videos ago now, I asked about compacting this silage, and come up with a brilliant idea. Quite simply, all we need to do is drive to this end, right, stop recording, hit it in reverse, drive back to wherever you want to stop, hit stop, and if you stick it in transfer and click drive, it'll just drive backs and forwards. Simples. Backs and forwards, and that'll compact it for as long as you like. Obviously you can adjust the speed a little bit if you want. Speed it up a bit. So what he's doing is actually driving the course and reversing it from here to here, and then driving from the finish to the start. So that works really well. So if you stuck around to the end of the video, then you might have learned something you didn't know. If you didn't, well, I'll see you next time. Thanks very much for watching. Take care.